Alright, what's going on, guys? So today we're going to be working on the Cheeto. I got some parts in, so we're actually going to be able to start plumbing the wiring harness. What do you guys call it? You guys called it the Octopus Orgy. I call it the Spaghetti Monster, but now we can actually, I got the knock sensors, we can actually tie down the harness onto the block where it needs to be and actually start running things. A little update on DIY stuff. We're pretty much done on this car. I have the cooling system rebuild edit almost completely finished. I still need to figure out the thermostat setup. This thermostat setup has been a pain in the ass. Of course, the DIY is not gonna show any of the shit that's gone down with this car as far as thermostat stuff goes because it's unexcusable. It's really just poor quality parts, which sucks. It's a URO thermostat, aluminum thermostat. I've never had a problem with URO, but all of a sudden their thermostat housings are garbage. So here's the first one that I ran. And the gasket sticks up way too much for some freaking reason. And so as I was torquing this down, it literally cracked. The housing literally cracked. So that sucked ass. So like a genius, I bought another one. And this one didn't crack, but the thermostat gasket is still just way too tall. It should not sit that high above the surface. So when it's bolted down, it doesn't seal. It doesn't sit flush with the cylinder head. I don't know if that's because they didn't machine that little surface. Gasket is recessed into deeply. They should have cut it more deeply. Or I don't know if this gasket, these batch of gaskets are just too thick, but something ain't right with that. So I ordered some OE gaskets from BMW. I'm gonna pick them up on Monday and hopefully it should seal because I started bleeding the system and it just started leaking coolant straight out of that. So that's not good. So we gotta hold off on that. I want to do a headlight DIY because we got this beautiful Depot glass headlights. These things look bitchin', but I have no idea what this wire is for, so I gotta contact someone about that. It's definitely not a ground wire. So I have no idea. So we have like left headlight, right headlight, like low beam, high beam, but I don't see any other light inside of there. So I have no idea what this wire is for, and I'm not gonna do a DIY and be like, oh, I don't know what this wire is for, or just freaking leave it hanging, because that's not cool. So I gotta figure out what's up with that, but I would really like to do a DIY on headlight install for that. Because it would be bitchin'. For the Cheeto, we got some stuff. We got our slave cylinder, finally. And we got this little trick line. So this is a clutch line. So this goes straight from the hard line out of the pedal assembly in the car, straight to the slave. So on my other manual swaps, you have like another clutch line that goes here to like a steel clutch line. So it's like two different clutch lines. This is pretty much that in one. So that's pretty fancy. So if you guys are doing manual swaps, that's definitely the way to go. I didn't really know about that. I just kind of had the other lines. And we got our knock sensors in. So these are going to go on. It's going to allow me to tie the harness completely down. So those are where the knock sensors go. And that little place right there. So I can't really bolt this whole harness down because it kind of covers that spot. So I was waiting really to get the knock sensors in to tie those things down so I could actually bolt the harness properly down and start running lines. Danny should be coming over today, so I think we're gonna start getting the front end completely on, and then we could probably start running the radiator and put all that stuff in there. So it's gonna be fun. It's gonna be a fun day of wiring, and I think we're probably gonna put the clutch stuff on too. I'm just gonna rub down the mating surface real quick because it's kind of rusty. That's better. Get some torque on these bad boys. Brand new knock sensors. Got a 13 up here. Ooh. All right, what a hot mess. Here's the auto trans harness. So I should probably cut that open and tie all those things off before they start causing messes. start doing ugly things. What else do we have for starter? That's a starter, that's a starter. Those are different sizes. So I took a second to clean up the wiring. So the harness for the mass airflow sensor, none of the wires were damaged, but the wrap was. Just cleaned up some loose wires that were just sort of hanging out in the bay. And I separated all of the autotrans wires, each individual wire, wrapped them, and then wrapped the whole harness together basically. So in the event that voltage does go through any one of these wires, they're not gonna touch each other or cause issues. So now we gotta figure out our starter wiring. We should probably get this guy plugged in too. That probably wouldn't be a bad idea. I did buy a new O-ring for this, which is nice. So we'll grab that real quick. Genuine BMW, baby. Things like 40 or 50 cents. Stupid cheap. Work with me here. Get our Vanos solenoid. All right, let's figure out this starter. So we got that, we got an 8. So let's run our 10 first. Yeah, those are alternators, so this is a starter wire. We got a little 8 going. I probably should have another nut for that. I feel like that's supposed to go somewhere. So that to me almost looks like the wiring harness end of it. It looks like another one of those. Ooh. So then we have the thick red boy. I kind of want to push that back like that. Get that down. And that comes from up above. Like that. Get a little nut going here. Boom. All right. Ugh. All right. Let's figure out hardware for this ugly ass dinosaur. So I found a little nut for that. It kind of looks ugly, so I don't know if I'm gonna use that or not. I'm betting we have better hardware elsewhere around here. All right, we could run that, fuck it. I also need to find the bolt that holds the bottom one. I have the bolt that holds the top one right here. So this project car came in clutch at a very nice time, because now I can use old shit from it that was gonna originally get thrown away, like this belt tensioner. I'm gonna see if we can get like an OBD2 style belt system going on, because the OBD1 cars use a spring tensioner, and I want to say they don't use an idler, but I like the OBD2 setup a lot better. So that's that. We do need to find a nut for that. And that's the top alternator bolt. So it's going to be similar to this, except it's going to be a decent amount shorter. So that's the same. So it's going to be that size. That's also the same. ¿Dónde está? Is that? That's trans. I have so much shit in here. Is that it? I think that's it. I think that's it. Fairly sure that's it. All right, let's put that back on. We got a crush washer. A washer on both of those.
Time for some alternation, baby.
I wonder if that's our Vanos. That's probably our Vanos. Ooh, I feel good about that. All right. Is that a coolant temp sensor? I feel like that's right. All right, getting sidetracked here. You know what I just remembered is that the OBD1 cards use a nut on the back of the alternator. So I think we might run two of these long ass ones. Ooh, look at that, I found a nut from the drive shaft. And it fits. And that's beautiful. Is that gonna be too long? No, it's actually perfect. Ooh, nice and tight. Oh, you power steering res. This line needs to come up a bit, actually. Ooh, we have alternation. Ah, that feels good. Feels good inside. That pulley is rusty. Jesus Christ. All right. Belt tensioner time. All right, we're gonna see if this even works. I don't know if this is gonna work or not. Okay. There we go. Look at that shit. We have a belt tensioner. All right, so Alex came through. Today's actually Easter, so you guys are about a week behind. And Alex came to ranch, so
let's do it.
We're gonna put this boy to work, get him comfortable. Oh, those are your hardware for it. This long guy goes through there. The longer, second longest. Yes, that one goes through there. And then that one goes through there. And then you take the whole thing and you put it on the car. There we go. We gotta put the power steering pulley on and we gotta put the tensioner pulley on. And then we can run our belt. I'm pretty sure this is the right belt. I don't know. This is a little Frankenstein belt setup. So that's an OBD2 pretty much setup. So the idler pulley, the belt tensioner, is all from an OBD2 car, so I don't know if this is gonna work, but hopefully it will. The power steering pulley goes on the power steering pump. I'm pretty sure those are their things. That should work. That's your bolt. That's your pulley. Pulley, your bolt through pulley. Pulley onto tensioner. There's your socket and driver. You'll see on the face of the tensioner where that goes. And I like to tighten it just until it actually compresses the tensioner, because that's how it'll sit. Just keep tightening it.
Keep tightening it?
Just keep tightening it. Tighten it until the tensioner compresses.
Okay. Like that.
Yeah, see what I'm talking about? Gotta get that back on the crank. All you got? Are we on everything? All right, so we let the camera charge for a little bit. The belt that we were using was too short, it didn't fit. So we made it fit. Some M50 cars, I think, don't have idler pulleys, so we just like totally ditched it and it fits. I don't think it's that loose. I don't know if that's gonna work or not, but hopefully it does. I think we're gonna get the front end on officially on And I also wanted to put the upper cowl back on now that we have the majority of the shit ran, and I kind of wanted to put the ECU in, so I think we're gonna start making moves on that. I lied, I'm not gonna put the cowl on. It's gonna make it a lot easier to put the intake manifold and all that stuff on with the cowl off. I can, however, put our DME on. Ooh, Red Label 413, baby. All right, so I'm just not gonna plug that into anything. We'll see how that works. If it works.
I'd like to take a moment here to appreciate our following sponsors. Quinn, turn around.
No.
All right,
that's
fine.
That's my fucking work.
You fucking piece of shit. I was fucking saying the hat, but.
Oh.
You fucking twat.
Yoshimoto.
All right, then get back to work, bro. Get back to fucking work.
What
the fuck you doing, bro? Get back to work.
No way if my boss is sponsoring.
Taking a break on the clock.
He doesn't even know.
Get back to work.
He doesn't even know about my channel.
Just roll up with a fucking 800 horsepower M3 one day.
I will. All right, so I reconnected the headlights, and there's a bunch of shit here that we're not using anymore, like the AC fans and the AC and the condensers. So there's a lot of connectors just freaking hanging out right now. So maybe in the future I'll come through and trim the harness down a bit, but for right now I don't think it matters. Cool. Temperature probe. Ooh, I lied. That actually needs to go on top of this. Get fucked. I gotta take these bolts off.
Okay. Yeah. I was about to say, something's not right here.
That goes under.
Place it over.
No, under.
It's been a while since I've seen a zip tie, my friend.
It has been a while.
You know, I honestly, I take that as an achievement, Gwen. I really do.
This is a properly built pile of shit, Alex. You understand this? This is a properly built pile of shit.
Properly.
There are piles of shit, and then there are proper piles of shit.
Yes.
This is a proper pile of shit.
Proper.
Rebuilt engine.
Pile of shit.
Manual conversion with brand new conversion parts, right?
But pile of shit.
Pile of shit because it's a cheap ass dusty car, but it also has fucking Frankenstein bits, which honestly make it fucking, you know what I'm saying? Like that belt, dude. Where else are you gonna find that genuine belt?
I don't know if genuine is the right word you're looking for.
That is OBD2 converted, M50 converted.
Three. It's like a OBD one and a half.
Yeah, dude.
Nice!
The headlight is actually held in there.
Ben.
See this? Look at this front end stability, bro. Of course, this shit's all still loose. Oh!
Woo!
Front end's back on, baby. Like, actually.
First in a while.
Most of the way.
Like nice and tight.
All
right. Nice and tight.
That's what I'm talking about.
Nice.
Yeah. I All right, so we got the front end completely back on, which is beautiful. Everything's nice and tight. We got the belts ran, kind of, yes. And we got the majority of, we got pretty much the whole bottom end plumbed for wiring. So our temp sensors, oil pressure, we got the alternator, the starter ran, all this stuff. The rest of the things that are hanging out are pretty much just top end stuff, like the mass airflow, idle control, throttle position. I don't know what that goes. Stuff is almost ready. So that is beautiful. Some solid progress on this beast today. Next time we're probably gonna be test fitting the radiator, getting the cooling system dialed in, and then we'll probably run the slave, and hopefully we have a pedal assembly soon-ish, but we'll see. Thank you guys so much for watching. Keep it fresh, and I'll see you guys later.
Dreaming in the dark, we are nothing more than dust.